I'm Zach Condon, and I do Beirut. I started the band Beirut.
The lights go on, the lights go on.
I used to work in a movie theater in Santa Fe that would play a lot of foreign films, especially like kind of festival stuff. So there was a festival of Balkan films. And I remember, you know, I'm just making popcorn at the time, but I remember hearing the music of Black Cat, White Cat, Amir Costa Rica. And I don't know, my jaw just kind of hit the floor when I heard the sound of the brass that was coming out of the theater. I couldn't believe that someone had taken it to that level of excitement and melancholy, all mashed into one. And so I knew that I had to find out what it was and how to do it. It was soon after that that I dropped out of school, saved up some money, and went off to Europe. That story lends itself to this whole kind of like soul-searching type story arc. But you have to understand that I live in my head, I live in a fantasy. And so really, the first album, Gulag Orchestra, didn't happen until I left Europe. And I was just kind of imagining the bits that I liked and even imagining the kind of fantasy that I would have liked it to have been, even. And just trying to kind of distill that into music. Because really, I thought of music always as escapism. And so, if it seems fantastical, that's because it actually is. In a sense, I was trying to kind of distill the sound that's always been there with Beirut throughout the albums, despite the, you know, logical jumping between locales and ideas. There was always something in the middle that carried it through. I think that kept people interested past a novelty, and I was really trying to dig into that with this album, hence the very simplistic approach. I actually rented a farmhouse upstate New York, about 2.5 hours north of the city, and basically just locked myself in there. It was basically just a piano, a ukulele, and a trumpet. I wanted to keep things really, really simple, because the idea was that I wasn't going to execute the entire album in that session. I was just going to write songs, which is something I've never done before, because I always used to home record, and I used to create the sound of a band by myself, and now I have a band, and that would be ridiculous.
But I'm just too young. One of my...
There's a lot of points in this album that are very personal. There's a lot of things that point to kind of looking back, to kind of trying to figure out where I came from. I mean, there's the quite literal one, there's the song Santa Fe, which is the city that I was raised in. But even the lyrics in the song are very much a kind of, I don't know, meditation on what it felt like to be a kind of dispossessed teenager in that town. And I just went back to listen to all these songs I'd written before the first album was released, and I don't know, I really found some very interesting nuggets, melodies.
To San Diego, San Jose.
It's definitely more personal than past albums. It just seemed the most obvious thing to do as I'm kind of growing into myself, kind of growing into an adult, growing into the story.